If you watched my most recent video, you will recognize this box. Now, inside of this, there are figures. And of course, these figures are by Mega House, as we can see right there on the bottom right corner. Now, if you understand Japanese writing, you would know exactly what's in this box, but I'll give you a hint. This is what we're looking at today. Carefully wrapped in tissue paper is today's subject. And with the tissue paper removed, we will see here that we have a figure from Gegege no Kitaro, as well as the Toei logo right up there in the top. This is the one and only Neko Musume from Gegege no Kitaro. As we can see here, Neko Musume in English as well. On the front, we can see the moon at the top, the trees, and even some spirit orbs around the side. Inside of the window is the figure, which is hard to see, but at the bottom, we get, of course, the name and a picture of our girl right here. Now, if we turn the box, we see a rather normal Neko Musume, looking rather nice, but ready to pounce for sure. Some more swirly orbs to symbolize the spirits, but let's take a look at the other side. Because on that we have basically the same thing, but she is in a far more bestial state here. The back shows everything in question, both her regular and bestial forms, as well as plenty of branding and legal info at the bottom. The top of the box is pretty plain, there's a little window, but you really can't see much through it, though it does have the branding and the name as well, all looking very nice. But now it's time to open this up. Now that she's out, you can actually see inside of the box, which looks really cool because there's the night sky and some more of those orbs in the background as well. I rather do like it. And in the bottom of it, you can see her name printed there once more. Now, once out of the packaging, she looks pretty darn good. It's a small figure, but that's what I expect from these Mega House figures. They're usually not huge, but they have a lot of great detail. So let's go over some of that now. There's nothing that fixes her to the stand, which is the only problem I really have with this figure. She just kind of sits there, which I guess is nice because there's no plugs that would potentially scratch the base, but either way, it kind of just makes it very, very limited in how you can display her. If you're really not with her in eye level, you can't really see much of her. But the sculpting is great. All the lines in her hair look really good. The dress is nice and wrinkled, but flowing rather well with the pose that she's in. And of course, if you turn her around, there is not an overly abundant panty shot right off the bat. Of course, you could try to get in there and really take a look, but it is sculpted to a point where there is all of that detail there, which of course I appreciate. And Neko Musume is basically the only bit of fan service that's in Gegege no Kitaro, so I understand it. Still, everything here is really clean and separated very well from one another. One thing that really stands out is her shoes. Super bright, very good contrast from her skin, and those legs just go on forever. Very clean, very nice, and the colors all work really well. Now, when you actually look her in the face, it's really well done. Everything's painted on and sculpted beautifully. It looks just like the character from the show. And that character is already, of course, rather nice. But of course, with Mega House's quality control, this was given a great level of detail that really does look wonderful. If she would stand something like this, I don't think I'd be as annoyed because then you could actually see her. But I guess they think, well, she's a cat, so this is the pose she'll naturally take. But it's really limited how much you can see. And I really like the base, but if you want to see the details, you're going to want to put it on top of something light, because putting it on something black basically obscures all of the details. There's Gegege no Kitaro branding on it, as well as some more of those swirly spirit orbs. But this figure actually has some additional accessories, because you can take off her hands, and forgive me, but you can also remove her head. Now, once removed, like many of the other figures I've gone over, you can remove the hair plate and then actually take the face off. If you swap the other plate on, put the hair back, she is now in her more cat-like form, with the glowing gold eyes and of course those sharp, sharp teeth. Very cool. And her additional hands allow her to show her claws. She's in full cat mode now, which looks pretty menacing. The only thing that I could see being a real problem here is those fingers. They are a little bit elongated and they're thin plastic, so be very careful with these. You could potentially break them. Over time, plastic tends to stiffen up and dry out, so you have to be careful with this type of stuff, so you'd have to attach them through the wrist. But still, with the right lighting, this looks gorgeous. And of course, when you put her in a regular mode, she looks just as beautiful. And while I love this figure, I will say though that it is limited. You have to put it up high, like I said, because if you're going to display her, nobody will see it from above. You have to be eye level with her to really see the details. But still, it is nice. Maybe you can find a clear piece of plastic so that you can display her like this, rather than putting a knife cap beneath her hand. All the same, it's Neko Musume, and any figures from Gegege no Kitaro are appreciated. This series was absolutely amazing, and Mega House knows what they're doing. The accuracy to the character from the show is wonderful. I couldn't ask for anything more, but still, I would like to be able to see it a little bit better if I put it on a shelf. There's really no QC errors to report here. Everything looks wonderful. Even the way her parts separate are blended incredibly well, so there's really no gaps. And this figure's not super expensive. You can get her anywhere between $50 and $70 if you play the market right. I think she's absolutely worth that, but still, I will say that I want to be able to see her better. Neko Musume was one of my favorite characters from Gegege no Kitaro in the end. She's a wonderful character, and in the new series, they made her so amazing. So I will gladly be displaying this, and I'm going to give Neko Musume a solid 7 out of 10. It's a little lower than I would like to have given this, mainly because, like I said, it's hard to really get any good angles of her. The figure itself is great, but the major flaw is within the design. If I were able to stand her up properly, she'd probably get an 8. I love her adaptability. Having additional parts is a great thing for a statue like this, but it's just hard to really get a good look at her. The point of figures is to display them so that you can look at them, and it's kind of hard to look at her, other than seeing her head and her hair and her dress. We want to see all the detail and love that went into her face, so it's kind of annoying to not be able to. Still, what do you guys think? Do you like this figure or not? Why don't you drop a comment below and let me know, and if you did like this video, make sure to like it. Now, I recently published another Japan vlog where I went to the Gegege no Kitaro Cafe, so I'm gonna link that on screen, and if you haven't seen it, then check it out. But with all that, thank you so much for watching, have an amazing weekend, and keep on collecting.